Good day viewers and welcome to the Polymer Update Daily News Show. This is Rinku Jain from the Polymer Update Mumbai office. Today's special news reel is sponsored by Delhi-based KPL International Limited, established about 2 decades ago. KPL International Limited specializes in the marketing of quality products in India, mainly in the field of chemicals, polymers, paper and paper chemicals sourced from globally acclaimed manufacturers. The company invites all to visit their stall number B5A, hall number 2 at Plast India 2018 to be held at Gandhinagar, Ahmedabad, Gujarat from February 7th to 12th, 2018. In Indian producer updates, as had been expected and reported by Polymer Update, PP, PE and PVC prices have been left unchanged by Reliance Industries Limited with effect from February 8, 2018. PP prices have been rolled over by MRPL with effect from February 8, 2018. In Asian market update for polystyrene and acrylonitrile butadiene styrene in PS, polystyrene prices gained this week in Asia. The price rise was attributed to high SM feedstock values coupled with strong import offers from overseas suppliers. CFR China prices of GPPS were assessed at the $1560 per metric ton levels, while CFR Southeast Asia prices of GPPS were assessed at $1590 per metric ton levels, both up by $10 per metric tons on the week. In India, prices of GPPS were assessed higher at the $1570 per metric ton CFR levels, a week-on-week rise of $20 per metric ton. Feedstock styrene monomer prices on Wednesday were at $1430 per metric ton CFR China levels in ABS. Despite high upstream SM, butadiene and ACN values, ABS prices were assessed steady in this week in Asia. CFR China prices of ABS were assessed at $2055 per metric ton levels, while CFR Southeast Asia prices of ABS were assessed at $2070 per metric ton levels, both unchanged from the previous week. In India, prices of ABS were assessed stable from last week at the $2060 per metric ton CFR levels in PVC import offers in India. CGPS Taiwan has offered its PVC resin suspension grade at the $1000 per metric ton levels for shipments in March 2018 on a CIF Nava Sheva Port basis. This offer attracts an anti-dumping duty of $33.94 per metric ton for buyers in India. A major Japanese producer has offered its PVC resin suspension grade TH1000R at the $1030 per metric ton levels, and TH1000, TH700, TH1300 grades are on offer at the $1040 per metric ton levels for shipments in March 2018 on CIF Nava Sheva port basis. This offer attracts an anti-dumping duty of $15 per metric ton for buyers in India. A Saudi Arabian producer had offered its PVC resin suspension grade at $1010 per metric ton levels for shipments in March 2018 on a CIF Nava Sheva port basis. In futures on China's Dalian Commodity Exchange on February 8, 2018, LLDPE prices are lower by RMB 55 metric tons from the previous settlement of at RMB 95.55 metric tons. PP rates are lower by RMB 100 metric ton from the previous settlement at RMB 92.64 metric tons. PVC is down by RMB 25 metric ton from the previous settlement at RMB 67.20 metric tons. The Maharashtra State Environment Department has proposed to ban the production, use, storage, distribution and sale of plastic items, citing the adverse impact on the environment effective from 1st March 2018. Polymer Update spoke with Mr. Ajay Desai, Vice Chairman of NEC Plast India 2018, and asked him to share his opinion regarding the ban.
I think education on littering should be the subject matter for environmental government and environmental people. plastic is not the problem. Plastic is a solution to lot of natural resources, and government should counter these particular issues very discreetly rather than doing it autocratically. This will slow down the growth of packaging industry to a great extent. The packaging industry of plastic has really brought lot of comfort and economy for common men as well as conveniences to various people of the nation. It is going to adversely affect the common man. I feel the common man and the consumer will pay for this extra cost which they will use to have alternate packaging help, and I am sure that the depletable resources like paper, metals will get consumed and create more trouble to the nation. It's the user habits which has really created this pressure. It is not plastic which is bad. It's the gift of 21st century to the world. And if used discreetly, the plastic can increase the use multiple times. And that will help maintaining the ecological balance also. I feel government should initiate students at school level to understand about plastics, their use, and the habits of disposal, which will inculcate a proper environment which will not have any pollution of plastics, but recycle of plastics will help the nation as well as the world.
If you have enjoyed watching this daily news video from Polymer Update and have found it to be useful for your business, please subscribe to our channel by pressing the button below. It's Thursday, February 8th. This is Rinku Jain. Thank you. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/polymerupdate and be sure to click the like button. You can also find us on Twitter at Polymer Update for the latest news from the plastics and petrochemicals industries. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and do not forget to hit the bell icon.